The Black Music Moment is brought to you by The Clean Store. Today we honor Lee Dorsey. Lee Dorsey was born in 1924 in New Orleans, Louisiana. With a career spanning the 60s and early 70s, he specialized in good humor music with a touch of second-line funk thrown in to make it all the more irresistible. In his early years, he was childhood friends with Fats Domino, but left New Orleans for Portland, Oregon when he was 10 years old. After serving in the Navy, he began a career in prizefighting in the Portland area under the name of Kid Chocolate. He had a reasonably successful career in boxing from 1951 till 1955, but soon after he returned to New Orleans where he opened an auto repair business and also began singing in the nightclubs. His first recording was Rock Pretty Baby with a B-side of Lonely Evening on the Rex label in 1958. He found little success until meeting famed songwriter and producer Alan Toussaint at a party. He was quickly signed to the Fury label, and their first hit together, 1961's Ya Ya, a song inspired by a group of children chanting nursery rhymes, reached number 7 on the charts and sold over a million copies. The follow-up, Do Re Mi, was successful, but the hits dried up, and needing to support a large family, Dorsey returned to running his auto repair business. Eventually, he was coaxed out of retirement by Toussaint, and they began recording together again. They collaborated on many hits, the biggest being 1965's Working in a Coal Mine. On this recording and many others, he was backed by another legendary group that we have featured, The Meters. Other tunes that made the charts for Dorsey include Ride Your Pony and the one we will hear today, Get Out of My Life, Woman. He spent the mid-60s touring internationally with The Meters as his backing band. That is way cool. He had one final hit, Yes We Can, in 1970, but that song became much more well-known later on as a hit for the Pointer Sisters called Yes We Can Can. A few follow-ups had some minor success, but Dorsey was hard-pressed to duplicate his big hit. He left music and returned to running his auto shop once again. He returned with one more album in 1977 that was met with moderate success and led to some opening spots on international tours for James Brown, Jerry Lee Lewis, and even The Clash in 1980. After that, he performed very little, and he passed away in 1986. His legacy was strong, and his tunes have been covered by the likes of John Lennon, Tina Turner, the Pointer Sisters, Devo, and of course, Jerry Garcia. Garcia first performed Get Out of My Life, Woman in 1984, and it showed up in his set list over 60 times in the next 10 years. The groove in this tune is just so funky, and it's one of the most sampled tracks in hip-hop history. Now, the Garcia Band changed the groove just a little bit. It's not quite is greasy second-line New Orleans and just a little bit straighter, but it's still super funky, especially for a Jerry Garcia band tune. So, here is Lee Dorsey and the 1966 original version of Get Out of My Life, Woman.
Get out of my life, woman. You don't love me no more. Nothing but a heartache by the pound.